Hi. Yeah, as I was working on my first tutorial from the new tutorial series Akai Force Plus One, and Plus One being a device in my setup, I noticed I spent a lot of time explaining how I've got everything set up with my audio interfaces in the PC for Ableton and in my user template in the Force. But that will be necessary for every video I make, so I thought instead of putting all that information in this video, let's make a separate video which I can link to. And that's what this video is about. I will be going over how I have set up my audio interfaces. Then I will go to the computer screen and show you the mixer window and Ableton, how I've set it up. And lastly, I will show how I set up my user template. Most of the devices in my setup are connected via USB, and some of them use MIDI, but that's because I like to set it up that way, that I can use the sequencers on the Digitech and the Digitone, for instance, and directly sequence certain devices. But other than that, they are all connected, and perhaps you can see it. I have two USB hubs, one being the overhub, and another one is a powered one from Transcendent, I believe. Let's move to the audio interfaces. By the way, this is my very professional rig for making these videos. All right. Let's get the cable a bit longer. Since Akai released firmware 3.0 or 3.1, it's possible to use an external audio interface. And that's the moment I bought this audio interface. It's a Behringer Euphoria UMC 1820. Decent audio interface. It has 8 inputs and 10 outputs, and that's that. I have also a digital mixer and audio interface. It's from the XR series, also from Behringer. It's XR18, and the outputs of the Euphoria are connected directly to this. Preferably I had it set up a different way, but since Windows, which the lower one is connected to, doesn't support aggregated devices, I need to do it this way. Otherwise, I would have had a few inputs left over for other devices. But that's not the case, so moving on. Going to the mixer window, here you see the inputs, and the first inputs that are the upper inputs on the mixer are used directly by the Digitech, the Digitone, Analog 4 and Novation Peak, and the other ones are used by the Euphoria audio interface that's connected to the Akai Force. Okay, by the way, the XR18 is a fantastic mixer. You also have a lot of possibilities, so can highly recommend it if you're looking for something like this. Well, here you see the same colors as before, and the same inputs basically. So the DT, the A4, and the Force, and other devices, and a stereo sum. I mainly use the last track, the stereo sum, for mastering, and I don't do a lot anymore in Ableton itself. I used to, but I don't do anymore. So carrying on, I will put the camera in the and then zoom in a bit. this enough? Yeah, this should be enough. A little bit back. Okay. Well, going to the user template now. Let's load it in. And I guess many of you by now will know how to make or create a user template. But if not, just set up all the tracks how you want them. Then save them. Tick the box save as template. And when it's saved, you can load the user template from the start screen. All right. These first four tracks are used for mainly for percussions and drum and effects and also some loops, but all coming from the Akai. And the first is the kick and or a bass. Then two percussion tracks, also with the ability to set loops and effects. These are all drum tracks, by the way. Then an FX one-shot track. Then I have four MIDI tracks, one going out to the AS1, the TD3, the Virus DI, and the Peak. Then I have five audio tracks to get the signal back into the Force. The audio signal. I will go into that a little bit further soon. Then I have four MIDI tracks for the Analog 4. The same for the Digitone, and 8 tracks for the Digitect. It's a shame though that I only use these tracks for configuration, or most of the time I don't use them. So yeah, hopefully Akai will one day create something, the possibility to hide tracks or something else, move all these tracks to a different window. But till that time, we have to deal with this. And it's also, not really handy when preparing live sets, because you want to have more tracks available and don't want all these unnecessary tracks in view. But okay, that aside, the thing is getting better and better, so hopefully in the next firmware update or somewhere soon it will change. All right, going back, the last channel or the last track is for sending program changes. I send them to the Digitect, and from the Digitect it's changed throughout all the Electron boxes. I set it up so that the quantization is off, the launch quantization, and the program change is set from clip, and it's sent to MIDI program change 0. And if I select the other clip, you see it will be 1. So if that's these are triggered, the patterns change on the Electron devices. By the way, all the other clips are set up that they don't trigger when I launch a scene. Only these tracks or only these clips are launched. Then the mixer. The kick and the bass track is going out to output 1 and 2, but when I use a kick and a bass, most of the time I only use a kick, so yeah. But when I use a kick and a bass, I'll split these channels into 1 and 2, and then I can record them separately into Ableton. The percussion is going out to output 3 and 4, and FX output to 5 and 6. Remember those for a second, because I will show them how I've set up the send effects, and these are connected, but I will explain that in a bit. Okay, then the audio tracks, standard, I have them set all to 7 and 8, except for the Virus, that's going out to 9 and 10, but these tracks most of the time change depending on my setup, what I do with the live set or with the jam session. And I use the Virus a lot, but I most of the time I sample it, and then I can use output 9 and 10 for something else. Okay, let's go over the tracks first. I have a track for the Torize AS1, the Dreadbox Typhon, the MAM MB33, and the Behringer TD3. So I, for layering, I put them together. In the future, I intend to use the AS1 and the Typhon for layering sounds. At the moment, I don't use the Typhon that much, or not at all, actually, because, yeah, it's a personal preference. I use a different master tuning, and I can't set the tuning of the oscillators. But they're working on it at Dreadbox, and I believe that in the next firmware update, that will be possible. So I'm waiting for that one. And of course, yeah, layering the acid boxes. Okay, that's speaks for itself. And as I said, the virus is most of the time sampled. So yeah. So that are these tracks. Now let's see what else. Oh yeah, the send effects. Let's go back to those. As you can see, I have send effect 1 and 2 are going out to output 3 and 4. And then send effect 3 is going out to output 5 and 6. And the last one is going out to output 7 and 8. So you see there's a direct connection. Let's see, going to this one. I only use send effects 1 and 2 for the percussion tracks, so they all go to output 3 and 4. Same here. And also, going back, the effects for one shots going now to output 5 and 6. And the same here, that's going out to 5 and 6. And this one is only used for most of the time for the acid boxes, but yeah, also for the other ones sometimes. And if this doesn't work, I use the normal insert effects. So yeah, that's that are the effects. What else? Oh yeah, I haven't set up any macros at the moment in the template. But I make them up as I go, as I'm preparing the set or the session. I will fill these as needed. I do, however, have set up with MIDI Learn some controls for the Digitech. I use a Launch Control XL, and I have 8 sliders on it, and I use it to control the volume. I want to control more, but as it stands, the firmware doesn't really support the things I want to do. So yeah, I have to do that in the software of Novation itself. But that's, at the moment, it will probably be fixed or otherwise implemented in the future, I guess, I hope. But for now, I only use the volume for the Digitech. Okay. That's the MIDI Learn part, that's the macros. Then I guess this is it. Yeah, there's more stuff to tell how I set things up once I started creating a set, but that will be for another video. So yeah, I will be working on the tutorials in the upcoming days, or the first tutorial in the upcoming days, and hopefully it will be ready soon. So yeah, till that time, I wish you all the best, and yeah, bye.